There are some common problems RV owners need to be aware of concerning the exterior of their RV. One is components on the RV start to wear out due to exposure to the elements, and another is water damage. Today we're going to do a preventive maintenance inspection on the exterior of the RV. Roof inspections will be covered in another segment. Let's get started. One of the most important things you can learn about maintaining a vehicle or RV is preventive maintenance. Preventive maintenance means you identify a problem early before it turns into a costly major repair. For example, if you discover a tire low on air and inflate the tire prior to leaving on a trip, you can avoid possibly having a blowout, which can cause lots of damage and delay your travel plans. Let's do a preventive maintenance inspection on the exterior of this RV. Learning how to do some RV preventive maintenance tasks yourself can be rewarding and can save money too. Areas we will inspect and discuss are inspecting for water damage, inspecting for sun damage, seams, seals, and sealants, RV tires, steps, door and storage compartment security. Inspecting for water damage. To stop a water leak early requires thorough, periodic inspections of all the RV roof and body seams and sealants. Always consult your RV owner's manual and/or your local RV dealer for sealants compatible with the different types of materials and surfaces on your RV. Anywhere the RV manufacturer cut an opening in the roof or the sidewall of your RV has the potential to leak. Nothing will hurt the value of your RV more than water damage. Today we will look at some easy preventive maintenance steps that will stop water leaks before they can start. If you look at the sides, back, and front of your RV, you will see where lots of components are installed in an opening cut into the RV's sidewall. When a manufacturer or a technician installs a component like the water heater or a window, some type of seal or butyl tape is used to prevent water from damaging the RV. For an added measure of prevention, the installer runs a bead of sealant above and slightly around the corners of the component they installed. Inspecting all these seals and sealants and taking corrective action when you discover a problem can prevent water damage on your RV. Check for any soft spots on the RV roof itself, especially around the roof seams at the front and rear of the RV. Thoroughly inspect all sealants on the roof around every opening cut into the roof. Look closely for any cracked or separated sealants that would allow water to penetrate the roof surface. Reseal any potential problem areas with the correct sealants for the surface. Consult your owner's manual or your RV dealer for proper sealants to use. If your RV has a fiberglass exterior, look and feel on the outside of the RV for any signs of delamination. Delamination is caused by water getting between the exterior fiberglass and the RV sidewall. When this happens, the exterior fiberglass starts to separate from the sidewall of the RV. You can stand at the front or rear of the RV and look down the side for any noticeable ripples or what looks like a bubble in the fiberglass. You can also press on the sidewalls to feel for soft spots or air pockets. If you feel the exterior fiberglass move, it is delaminating. In most cases, delamination starts around openings that were cut into the sidewall, like a window or the water heater. Repairing delamination can be expensive, so inspecting these areas on a regular basis will help identify a potential problem early before delamination starts. Inspecting for sun damage. Lots of damage on the exterior of your RV is caused by the sun and/or the lack of maintenance. Other damage can be accidental. When you inspect the exterior of the RV, look for anything that is out of the ordinary. When your RV is exposed to the elements for extended periods of time, the exterior starts to show signs of wear. The sun takes its toll on RVs. The paint starts to fade, and products made of rubber and vinyl dry out, crack, and start to deteriorate. If you neglect it for too long, it's too late to do preventive maintenance. After it's too late, parts and pieces of the RV need to be replaced. You can start by inspecting all the plastic components on the exterior of the RV. As you can see, the damage can be significant. Most of the damage was caused by the sun, and the lack of maintenance contributed to the current condition. Other damage was accidental, like the electric power cord hatch door that got crushed by the slide out more than one time. Seams, seals, and sealants. You can inspect some seals and sealants without a ladder, and others will require a ladder. When you inspect the seals and sealant, look to make sure there are no cracks or separations in the sealant that would allow water to get in. And look for any sealant that does not adhere to the surface it is sealing. If any of the sealant is loose or separating from the surface, you can remove the loose sealant prior to resealing the area. Apply more sealant over any cracks you find in the old sealant and anywhere you remove the old sealant. A silicone sealant can be used on fiberglass and aluminum siding, but never use any petroleum-based products on rubber roofing. If you discover any bad seals during your inspection, they need to be replaced. If you want to tackle the project yourself, visit our RV Education 101 YouTube channel and search for our RV Sun Damage Repair video to see how it's done. RV tires. When you are not using the RV, the tires should always be covered to protect them from sun damage. When tires are exposed to the sun, over time they will have checking or cracking on the tire sidewalls. These cracks are detrimental to the life of the RV tires. If you inspect your tires and notice cracks in the sidewall, have the tires inspected by a professional before using the RV again. Avoid storing the RV on any petroleum-based surfaces like asphalt. If the RV is stored on the ground, block the tires with blocking that is larger than the tire's footprint. RV steps. The steps on your RV will work better and last longer if you periodically lubricate the moving parts. If the paint on the steps is wearing off or chipped away, it is easy to spot paint them. Sand the area that needs repainted, prime the surface with a good primer, and repaint using a high-quality paint that matches the color of your steps. Door and storage locks. To keep the entry door and compartment door locks working properly, lubricate the lock cylinders periodically. I personally use BoSealed T9 to lubricate any moving parts on the RV. Preventive maintenance inspections on an RV are easy to do, but the important part is repairing whatever you find wrong during the inspections. If you are not comfortable making the repairs yourself, schedule an appointment with your local RV dealer to have the work done. To learn more about using and maintaining your RV, visit RVOnlineTraining.com. Happy camping.